I want to show you the process that I've been going through to do my asset handling in Phoenix. Out of the box, there's a hex package that wraps ESBuild, and it works fine. There's nothing wrong with it, but I've been using Bun myself, and I'd like to show you how I set it up and configure it. So to show this off, we're going to make a new project here. We're going to run mix Phoenix new, and then we'll call this Phoenix Bun Demo. And this is going to take a little bit to run, so we'll come back to you in about a minute or so. All right, here is our new project. We will cd into it, and we are going to run mix ecto reset, and then we're going to run mix Phoenix server. And then here I have the server up here running on the default port, and then I'm going to hop into a particular file here, this home.html.hex file. I'm just going to add a DOM element here with some classes that we will recognize when we see it, something like text background 200, text indigo 800, padding 2, rounded, sure. We're basically going to put this in. We have some text that's going to use Tailwind classes that we can see whether it's functioning or not. And here is that element we just added. So we're just going to use this to make sure everything's working. Now, quick word as to how all of this asset handling stuff works out of the box. So clearly there is an assets directory here. There's a Tailwind config file, and there is no package.json in here. Everything is done without touching npm out of the box. So there is one JavaScript dependency. It's this top bar thing here, and it's just copy and paste it in. And actually there is another dependency, which is all of this stuff here in Phoenix from this Phoenix Live View package here. This is actually getting imported from the deps folder at the top of your project. Yeah, I'm not sure if it's really explained anywhere how you're supposed to do this, but if you ever need to write a library or anything that uses JavaScript in some way, the way that you do it generally is putting a package.json file at the top of your library, and then in that package.json you kind of specify these build assets that live in priv static, or they can really be anywhere. And then the thing that makes it all work together, I will show you, the thing that actually makes it function is right here in this line where we configure ESBuild. There's this node path addition here that adds the deps folder. So because that is added to the node path, and because there is a package in here, and because that folder has a package.json, then what happens when you try to import this in JavaScript is going to look for a folder in the node path that has a package.json, and that's what actually makes this work. So just thought that might be interesting ground to cover, because I think this kind of feels like magic. Like, how does this actually do it? Well, that's how it does it. So let's jump back to that config file here. This is obviously the thing that glues everything together. There's a config line for ESBuild, config section for Tailwind, and we can see that these are command line arguments. So both of these are using their respective CLIs to do everything. That's pretty self-explanatory, but there's one other place that we need to care about, and that is in the dev file. There is a watchers config right here, and this is very important. This is what actually runs the dev time watchers for ESBuild and Tailwind. Something that's kind of interesting that isn't immediately obvious is this atom here is actually the command that's going to run, because we see this here, this can just be anything. We can come in here and we could call this app if we wanted to, and then call it app there. That's totally fine. But this is actually the command that's going to run. If we go to the documentation for Phoenix Endpoint, we can see here what's actually happening is this command is going to be used, and then these are all the arguments that are going to be passed to it. There is this module function syntax, and that is actually what's being used here, but we are going to use this version when we replace it with Bun. So setting all that aside, what are we actually going to do? How would we go about about bringing a package.json file in here, managing the assets ourselves. And firstly, why would you want to do it? Well, in my mind, the big reason is it's a little bit easier to manage a whole bunch of flags going to ESBuild if you actually have a script that you can write, you can do whatever you want. You don't need to pass like 50 flags to the ESBuild CLI. I think that's a little bit of an improvement. Also, if you want to do very custom things, it may not even be possible to do what you want to do with the CLI. If you want to add live Svelte or live view or any more advanced things that you need to bundle, it's probably not going to be possible to do it with the CLI. But luckily, here in the docs, we actually have a full ESBuild script that we can literally just dump in here into this build.js file. So that is exactly what we are going to do. We're going to go to the assets directory, and we are going to make that build.js file, and we're going to paste it in. And the only thing I'm going to change is I'm going to set this to ESNext. I actually recently made a PR to change this, so I don't know. Maybe it's ESNext by the time you're looking at this, or ES2022 or something, but I personally think ES2017 is a little out of date or a little old at this point, so we'll go ahead with that. We got our build script. Luckily, we can just paste it pretty much directly out of here. Now we need to do two things. We need a package.json file, and then we need to actually install our bundler. Now, like I said, I'm going to use bun to run my scripts, and I'm going to continue to use ESBuild as the bundler. To proceed with that, you of course need to have bun installed. You can pretty easily do that just by going to the bun website and following the instructions. I'm going to assume you have it installed, and if you do, you should have this bun command and this bunx command. First off, in this new directory, you can run bun init and more or less just accept these defaults, and then we're going to change a couple things. We don't need the readme. We can just delete that. Nothing wrong with keeping it if you want, but we don't need it for anything. Second off, we don't need this entry point it creates. We can remove that. And then we're going to reflect that change in the package.json file here. So we do not need this module index.ts line. And I am not going to use module resolution or type module. Module resolution. We don't need to get into what that actually does or means, but suffice to say, you probably aren't going to be using it. Now we can install ESBuild. To do so, we'll run bun add ESBuild, and boom, there we are. Now we can test out our build script simply by running bun run build.js, and it has succeeded, which is awesome. I'm going to do one other step, which is I'm going to add some helper scripts in here. I like to have a little script section. So I like to basically have this kind of setup here, a build, watch, and deploy script. That way I can just run, build, watch, or deploy, and I don't need to specify the file or anything like that. And we can test out that that works by just running bun run build, and that should work. So everything's good to go there. The only thing we need to do now is just adjust the watchers, first of all, in dev.exs. So we're going to remove ESBuild, and instead we're simply going to do this, just bun run watch. It's just that simple. I'm also going to come here to this config ESBuild bit here, just take that out. And then I'm also going to open up this mix.exs file here. I'm going to remove the ESBuild package, and then I'm going to change this line here that before was ESBuild Phoenix bun demo minify. Instead, we're going to do bun run deploy. However, this is going to run at the root directory of the project, so we need to pass this current working directory assets flag. And in this one right here, we're going to say build, and in this one, we're going to say deploy, because that is what these helpers do. They build everything, and this one is like the final deploy command. We can also remove this ESBuild install thing here. If you want to, of course, you can have something that makes sure bun is installed here if you want. Let's test that out. We'll run mix assets build, and it seems to have compiled correctly. We can also test the deploy command, and looks like we are missing something, so let's open that up again. Looks like we forgot to delete the ESBuild line, so we'll do that, and then we'll test it again. Seems to have worked, but let's test by using that DOM element we added. So it looks like we have a problem with the watcher, and I think I know what it is. If we open back up the dev.exs here, there is one thing thing we forgot to do here. And that one thing is basically this. You can pass a CD flag here, and we simply forgot to tell it to CD to the assets directory. So once we've done that, it should work properly. So let's come to our server terminal here. We'll stop it, and then we'll restart it. And there we go. It looks like we don't have any errors. So let's take a look at the browser. And it looks like our CSS is working correctly. Let's go back to that file, which I believe was in libwebcontrollers in this file here. Let's try changing this from indigo to yellow, and that should have triggered a rebuild of everything, which it did. And there you go. What do you know? It's yellow. Our CSS seems to be compiling correctly. So we got bun. Now, one thing I want to show you is how simple it is to use TypeScript. Now, this is nothing special really about bun. This just has to do with ESBuild, but ESBuild pretty much just understands TypeScript out of the box. So all we have to do, if we want to use TypeScript, we can just come to this line here, change this to point at app.ts, and then come here and change this to a TS file, and we will restart everything just to make sure that everything is still working. And it seems to have compiled correctly, and indeed everything seems to be loading correctly. So that is pretty nice. A nice aspect of ESBuild. You can pretty much just do this out of the box and get TypeScript for free, or get TypeScript very easily. The next thing I almost always do is replace this Topbar import here with an actual node module rather than a copy and pasted module. I think it's a little easier to manage that way. So we're actually going to delete this vendor directory, and then we can simply, from the assets directory here, we can simply run bun add topbar, and then we will open up the app.ts file this time and change this from a path to a bare module name here, and everything should continue to work correctly. I will just restart it just to make sure, and indeed everything seems to be working correctly here. There shouldn't be any errors in the console or anything, and indeed there is not. Now, what if you want to run a TypeScript build script here? What if you wanted this ESBuild file to be .ts? Bun actually works out of the box with TypeScript in a lot of cases. So we can actually just change this to a TS file. And at that point, this is one benefit to defining the helper scripts here. Then we can just change them right here. We can run bun run build. Well, we weren't in the right directory, but if we go to the right directory and we run build, we can see it works the exact same. So that is one nice part about bun. Now, the tricky thing is when module resolution comes into play. That's one file that bun knows how to transpile on the fly. It gets more complicated with changing things like this tailwind config file, where other things are going to look it up, and you know, it may work fine for you, but there's a lot of cases where it doesn't. So feel free to experiment with it. If you want everything TypeScript, you can make it work. Personally, I leave most of my config files as JavaScript. I will occasionally use TypeScript for this build file itself, and then I write all of my actual application JavaScript in TypeScript, but that's about it. It is, by the way, also very easy to install bun in a Docker image. This is what I tend to do in my Docker images. I just run the bun.sh/install script, download it with curl, pipe it into bash. That's pretty much what I do in the main build stage of my Docker files, and then just copy it out with the rest of the assets. The build script does run a little bit faster. In some cases, if you have a complicated build script, it could even run quite a lot faster. So that is a nice little benefit there. I also think, in my experience, it results in smaller node module directory sizes. I think it has a different algorithm for like resolving node modules that can have some benefits. It's just a nicer quality of life experience overall. That combined with the fact that it can more readily execute TypeScript out of the box is pretty nice. That's some of the reasons why I personally use it. But yeah, hopefully this was helpful to you. Let me know if you'd like to see anything different in the future. And of course, if you've watched the end, I really appreciate that. I hope you have an amazing rest of your day. Thanks.